Hi everybody, welcome to Narex channel. Today I'll explain how to use an OLED display like this one in the Narex. So let's get started. Open the Linux terminal, enter inside Narex space, Narex, execute make distclean to clear previous configuration. Make this clean. Now we need to check if our board has support to OLED display SSD1306. LS config STM32F103 minimum SRC STM32 SSD1306.C. Okay, our board has support. Now we can execute the command to configure the STM32F103 minimum NSH profile. Tools configure.sh STM32F103 minimum /NSH. Now we can execute make menu config to select the options to enable the OLED display. So make menu config, enter inside system type, STM32 peripheral support, and enable I2C1. Exit again. Enter inside device drivers, enable I2C driver support, enable video device support, enable frame buffer character driver. Now we can exit. So go to LCD driver support, enable it, and enter inside it. Enable LCD driver front-end, enter inside LCD driver selection, and enable the UG2864HSWEG01 OLED display model. Go to SSD1306 interface and change it to I2C. We can exit again and again. Go to applications configuration, example, frame buffer driver example. Enable it, exit, and finally exit and save. Now we can execute make to compile the source code. Okay, the source code was compiled. Now we can flash the firmware inside the board. If you don't know how to do that, please watch this video explain. Ctrl R, open OCD, Ctrl L. Okay, the firmware was flashed correctly. Now I will show how to wire the OLED display in the STM32F103 minimum board. Okay, let's go. It is very easy to connect the OLCD in the STM32F103 mini. First, we need to connect the VCC pin. To 5 volts. Then connect the GND to G-pin. Connect the S clock, the SCL to B6. And connect the serial data SDA to B7. Also, you need to connect the USB serial adapter. So, connect the GND to G-pin. Okay. Connect the RXD, the receive pin, to A9. Connect the TXD or transmitter pin to A10, to pin A10, and basically that is it. And now we can connect the USB cable and connect the USB serial in the computer. We connect the OLED display in the board and the USB serial adapter. Now we can execute Minicon to get it working. Minicon, reset the board. Let's see if the frame buffer 0 was created. ls/dev. Okay, the FB0 is here. Let's see if the frame buffer application is here. Okay, the application is also here. We can run it now. And I will show the display. Okay, the frame buffer application worked correctly. Now we can create your own frame buffer application, or you can use some default Linux application with a small modification to get it working on Nurex. Okay, I hope you had enjoyed this video. If you are not subscribed to Nurex channel, please subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye bye.